people think you're from the future if you know the past real well, because we had it right. We got off the track and food became more about distribution than about food and food quality itself. You know, what travels the best, what's convenient, what can be done cheap. Because of that strive for convenience and affordability, we typically eat the same four fish, the same four types of animals, the same four vegetables. If somebody had a choice, and they're like, color me a picture. And if you had a choice between the big box of crayons and that little three pack that they give kids at chain restaurants, who's gonna choose the three pack? Our bodies seem to do best when we eat a diverse range of species, plants, whatever it may be.
Dude, would it be okay to get like a handful of these little guys?
Absolutely.
And a handful of these little guys?
He has always had the right attitude, and he has had, you know, the right approach to anything that comes your way. You know what I mean? We can make it work.
Locally caught by a local fisherman gets the first level of priority above anything else.
You got the cutest little faces. Little smiley face. Maybe the two bigger ones?
Two bigger ones? Sure.
Yeah. I've dedicated most of my life to studying the fish in this ocean in culinary applications. And I still see stuff I've never seen before. Like, there is no way to know about every single thing out there in one lifetime.
I love that little thing they do. Don't pay any attention to me, I'm a rock.
That's right.
I'm a rock, keep moving.
You don't see me.
What gets us interested is, you know, not just being able to eat fish that aren't typically eaten and or underappreciated, but like other pieces of the fish that people wouldn't normally eat. You know, and fish guts are disturbing to some, but like those same people eat hot dogs. We're not in a place in this country where we can throw food away. You know, there's a lot of our population that's malnourished. There's a lot of people who don't know where their next meal is coming from. One part of the fish alone that's not typically eaten, or people just don't know how to identify it or don't want to deal with it, there's so many applications. As a chef, it gives you so much to play with. None of this is new. As much as I'd love to take credit for it, it comes from our past, it comes from different cultures, different places, and a different time in a lot of cases, but I think it's time to kind of bring it back to the forefront. If we're trying to design things and we want them to go big, it's important that we give that idea legs, you know? I don't care about money, you know? I mean, I'm happy. If I get my few waves in the morning and I get to play with fish, it's cool. But I know that nothing's gonna go mainstream unless it can be monetized. Where Wrench is kind of the test kitchen and the Dr. Frankenstein's laboratory, the fun of Shootz is that it's smaller, more streamlined, and still kind of showcases a lot of the creativity and the fun things that Wrench is able to do, but with Shootz, it's got the potential to go mainstream. And I mean, the only real limiting factor is the imagination, you know, the guys willing to get out there and risk their lives to catch it, and the imagination of the people cooking it. This really isn't as much about my restaurant or, you know, the town I live in, as much as it's about this planet we live on, the ocean that we're lucky enough to play in and, you know, feed us, and basically the health of the human species.